Dexter ill?
Is Dexter ill today?
Mr. Kirk, Dexter's in school.
I'm afraid he's not, Miss Fishmore. Dexter's truancy problem is way out of hand. The Baltimore County School Board have decided to expel Dexter from the entire public school system.
Mr. Kirk, I'm as upset as you to learn Dexter's truancy. But surely expulsion is not the answer.
I'm afraid expulsion is the only answer. It's the opinion of the entire staff that Dexter is criminally insane.
That boy needs therapy.
Judy, psychosomatic.
That boy needs therapy.
Lying down on the couch.
Well, what does that mean?
You're a nut. You're crazy in the coconut.
What does that mean?
That boy needs therapy.
I'm gonna kill you.
That boy needs therapy.
Granny Gazoo, let's have it, you. I want to count three.
That boy needs therapy.
He was white as a sheep.
And he also made false teeth.
Avalanches above, business continues below.
Did I ever tell you the story about
cowboys?
Midgets.
The Indians. And what frontier psychiatrist?
I felt strangely hypnotized.
I was in another world. The world of 20,000 girls.
And milk.
And rectangles.
Two and optometrists.
A man with a golden eyeball.
And tighten your buttocks.
Or juice on your chin.
And I promised my girlfriend I could...
The violin.
Psychosomatic. That boy needs therapy.
Lying down on the couch.
What does that mean?
You're a nut. You're crazy in the coconut.
What does that mean?
That boy needs therapy.
I'm gonna kill you.
That boy needs therapy.
Granny Gazoo, let's have it, you. I wanna count three.
That boy needs therapy.
He was white as a sheep.
And he also made false teeth.
Other than a person.
A bird?
Yeah.
Sometimes a parrot talks.
Folks, welcome back to another episode of the ROGGASCH Podcast. I know I am absolutely over the moon with this one. I recently took a vacation to Bohemian Grove. That's right, folks. Yours truly went on a little recon mission for the people. I'm going to get to the heart of the matter time. That's what I'm doing. I'm getting to it like Don Henley. Heart of the matter. Rip Glenn Frey. I went to Bohemian Grove, had some great experiences, met some wonderful people, ate some really good food, and recorded much of my vacation, quote unquote. Not really a vacation, it was more work. At least that's what I'll be claiming on my taxes. And I Jason Rogash discovered the secrets of Bohemian Grove, or at least some of the secrets of Bohemian Grove. I don't want to give too much away right now. I'm going to let you listen for yourself. I'm going to let you absorb this very special episode of the Rogash podcast. Of course, the song we just listened to was Frontier Psychiatrist from the Avalanches, which is a terrific band from, I think, Australia. So, folks, sit back and enjoy my trip to Bohemian Grove. And at the end of the podcast, we'll get back together and we'll do a little recap. All right, folks, buckle up. This is a hot one.
All right, folks. Well, this is a very special episode of the Rogash podcast. I'm sorry about the sound. I am on vacation, and I'm recording this on my handy tape recorder, which I've had since I was 20. I used to be the mixtape guy. You know, the guy in high school, or junior high, high school, you go to and you say, I don't need a mixtape. I was that guy. But anyway, I'm here in Bohemian Grove. This is the fourth podcast, which I can't believe I made it this far. I really can't. I can't believe that the FCC hasn't banned this thing yet, or at bare minimum, YouTube hasn't decided that they've had enough with me. Thank you, YouTube, for not. Thank you, Google. Thank you, Alphabet. But folks, we're Bohemian Grove. Now I know what you're saying. They're like, Jason Rogash is at Bohemian Grove. This is a big deal. This is a big deal. This is kind of monumentous. Monumental or monumentous? I don't know. It's big, and that's what I'm about. Now, folks, I'm coming to you live right outside. I'm not live. I'm recording it. But I'm coming from right outside my hotel, which is a lovely Marriott here at Bohemian. It's the Bohemian Grove Marriott, which is just... I do have one complaint. The pool closes at 6:30 p.m. Yeah, it does not seem a little bit early for a pool to close at 6:30 p.m.? Like, I mean... And by the way, during the daytime, there's kids there. They're like, I want to do my laps. Because I'm a lap swimmer. I swim laps. You know, I don't have fun in pools. I go for the exercise. I like to burn calories. But anyway, that's neither. I just think, by the way, last night when I got in, I didn't know it was 6:30, and I'm out there at 10 o'clock and doing my laps, and they brought a bunch of dudes out there, and they were like, you got to get out. And I'm like, really? It's a pool I paid. You can see my, they're like, we don't care. Go, bounce. And they showed me the sign. I saw the sign. I said I didn't see the sign, but I saw the sign. Anyway, so I'm a Bohemian Grove. I'm outside the Marriott. I'm having a great time. Breakfast was good. I had a poached egg and some grapefruit, which was nice. I don't usually eat like that. I don't even know why I ordered it. I don't like grapefruit or poached eggs, but I ordered it because I panicked. I'm kind of like trying to be undercover here, like trying to be a different person. I don't want anyone to know that Jason Rogash is here, because what happens when the Bohemian Grove finds out Jason Rogash is there? Yeah, I'll tell you what's going to happen. The shit is going to hit the you-know-what. The you-know-what being a fan. And that, it's going to hit it. And it's going to get disgusting. And have you ever... Think about what they would do to me. I don't even know if I'd get home alive. I'm surprised I'm not on a no-fly list. As a matter of fact, when I bought my ticket, I bought it online. And when I put my credit card, it took a minute. It took a little longer than it should have to go through. And I was like, uh-oh, new world. So, I'm here. New world order probably already knows, except... You use my credit card. You have to. You can't get a hotel room without a credit card. I mean, good luck trying to do that, right? I mean, you'll stay in some flea-bottom hotel, but I don't want that. I want to stay in a Marriott with a nice pool. Anyway, okay, so I'm the Bohemian Grove. I'm having a good time. And I'm about to go to the actual Bohemian Grove itself. I got a map from a guy who works here at the hotel. He's like, I can show you the back way to Bohemian Grove. And I was like, you got it, pal. How much? And he, $25 for this map, which he drew on a napkin. I think it looks pretty accurate. I don't have a north, south, east reference or any, I don't know which way is which, so I'm just going to start walking in the general direction that I think this thing is written in, because I think he must have been talking about, like, the front of the Marriott, because that's where the wall is, on the, yeah, I'll post the picture of the map, on this video. Okay, so, folks, we're through the woods here, we're going to head through the woods here, I'm going to, let you go until I find something, so give me, I'm just going to shut the recording off, I'll be right back. Okay, folks, I am back, here at Bohemian Grove, Jason Rogash. Big time. No, it's doing the work for the people. I'm here for you. I'm here to shut this business down. I'm here to get it. I'm here to find it and shut it down. And I'm in the woods right now, and I'm outside of the Bohemian Grove camp. At least I think it's a Bohemian Grove camp. It could be a KOA campground. I don't know. But it doesn't matter, because it's Bohemian Grove. We're in the area. So we're just going to keep walking until we find something. We'll eventually run into it. Guess what? Oh, Jesus. Disgusting. Oh, you guys, you know what I'm looking at? I know Bohemian Grove now. I'm looking at a Republican dude banging another Republican dude in the woods. Oh, that is, I guess I meant, oh wait, never mind, no, that's two trees. That's just one tree leaned up against another tree. You know when you see one tree leaned up against another tree and it looks like two dudes having anal sex? You know how that happens to you sometimes? That just happened to me. No big deal. Let's just keep moving. So we're walking here. Oh, I can see guards. They look like Whackin' Hut guards, maybe? I don't know. I can't see where they're, I don't know what they're dressed like. Maybe not Whackin' Hut guards, but they're certainly dressed. They could probably be, they're either Whackin' Hut guards or they're members of the Geek Squad. They're one of the two. I can't tell. Let's go walk up on them and see. Let's find out. Let's do some investigating. And I gotta walk up on them. They're gonna ask me my name. And I gotta think of a fake name. So I'm just gonna walk in, thinking of a fake name. I'm gonna think of a fake name. Think of a fake name. Think of a fake name. Oh, hello! Yes! No, my name? My name is, Jason Rogash. Shit. No, what am I? Oh, you like my camera? Thank you. Yes, it's a little bit older. Soviet era. What's that? No, yes, it is, it's magnetic tape. No, I'm not poor. No, I'm not Serbian. I don't know. No, I'm not a time traveler from the past. Okay, you know what, guys? I'm just gonna keep moving. By the way, like your outfits. Oh, you, thank you. No, you're on the Geek Squad. Okay, you guys do good work. You guys actually hooked up a stereo system in my house once. Thanks, I appreciate it. Is there a Best Buy nearby? There is. It's the Bohemian Grove Best Buy. Cool. Excellent. Suckers, I'm not gonna go check out the Bohemian Best Buy. Why would I do that? Why would I go to Bohemian Best Buy? One Jason Rogan, Whackin' Hut / Geek Squad guys, zero. Okay, let's keep moving. So we're going through here. I'm gonna cut out the microphone again, cause it's getting a little hot. My tape recorder here is actually, it gets very hot. It gets up to 85 degrees, 90 degrees on my thigh here, so I'm gonna shut it down. I'll kick it back up when we find something. We're recording. Okay, we're recording. Jason Rogan back here, Bohemian Grove. This has been a hell of a day, by the way. We've already been encountered guards. I just was followed. I had a guy follow me. And I don't know. And he had a dog. And it was a small dog. It was like one of those Pomeranians, but it's still, he was following me. I don't think there's any question that he kept doing something with his ear. He kept reaching towards his ear like he was talking to somebody. I couldn't tell. My eyesight isn't so great. But that's a different story. I have some cataracts issues. But anyway, and an astigmatism. If you're around astigmatism, you guys know what I'm saying. Contact lenses. Anyway, let me just get focused here on Bohemian Grove. Okay, so we're walking up on... Oh, I hear music playing. Oh, guess what they're doing? At my hotel, they're having some kind of Bohemian Grove soiree. Like some kind of dance. Like some kind of party. I don't know what's going on. I think we should check this out. I'm going to roll in here. Anyone ask me, I stay here. This is my, I can't believe I'm staying in the same hotel as Bohemian Grove. Oh, look at them. Look at them get out of there. They're, oh, look at these limousines. Oh, they're Hummer limousines. Oh, of course. New World Order. Very young New World Order, too. They're really young. God, they're like teenagers almost. I mean, they're young. Wearing tuxedos and dresses and, oh, they're wearing corsages and boutonnieres. Sick fucks celebrating their depravity. I'm going to follow them in and see what's going on here. Oh, there's balloons everywhere. You know if there's some evil going on if there's a balloon arch. And guess what, folks? There's a balloon arch. How about me? Blue and white, a balloon arch. Oh, these sick fuckers. You know what? They didn't bet on one thing. They didn't bet on old Jason Rogash. That's what they didn't bet on. Always bet on Jason Rogash if you're in a casino. And I was going to use always bet on black, but I'm not black. So just always bet on... Okay, I'm walking. Oh, look at this. I hear it playing. Oh, guess what's playing? Can you hear it? It's Oh, What a Night. Oh, I hate this. Oh, yuck. Yeah, this is pure evil in here. It's like, I bet, you know what I bet's going on here? I bet we're going to walk through these doors, and we're going to see, like a Eyes Wide Shut, you know, kind of a situation. So let's just all get ready for that. Going through. They're taking pictures. Oh, they're smiling and taking pictures of their evil. This is disgusting. Another bunch? Fucking another balloon arch. Whoa. This is really, creepy. I bet there's 666 balloons in it. I bet there was. I'm not going to count them because that's a long... I bet there is. They got a banner. Oh, they have a banner above. Nice. Let me get my glasses out here. And welcome, class of 2016. Okay, we're at a prom. We got to go. This was a prom. This might have been a New World Order prom or just a regular prom. I don't know. But we're at a prom. Okay, that makes sense. No, they're the kids. That makes total sense. Hey, no, I stay here. I'm not. I know I'm a little bit old to be at the prom. No, thank you. Just looking for my room. Oh, third floor. Yes, okay. Yes, I know the pool closes at 6:30. Thank you, Steve. All right, folks. Well, this has been one hell of a trip. I'm going to regroup. I'm going to let this my tape recorder cool down a little bit, and my camera as well. Plus, I got to recharge the battery. My camera only has like 30 minutes of battery, and it's an external battery, and it's really heavy. So my shoulder hurts a little bit. So I'll be right back.
Who died?
Our Akita.
Hey, Vita. You make fun, yet I'm the one attempting to do some good. Or do you really want a neighborhood where people piss on your stoop every night? Bohemia, Bohemia's a fallacy in your head. This is Calcutta. Bohemia is dead.
Dearly beloved, we gather here to say our goodbyes. Here she lies. No one knew her worth. The late great daughter of Mother Earth. On these nights when we celebrate the birth. In that little town of Bethlehem, we raise our glass, you bet your ass, to La Vie Bohème.
La Vie Bohème. La vie bohème. La vie bohème. La vie bohème.
To days of inspiration, playing hooky, making something out of nothing. The need to express, to communicate, to going against the grain, going insane, going mad. To love intention, no pension. To more than one dimension, to starving for attention, hating convention, hating pretension, not to mention, of course, hating dear old mom and dad. To riding your bike midday past the three suits, to fruits, to no absolutes, to absolute, to choice, to the village voice, to any passing fad. And us for once instead of a them.
La vie bohème. La vie bohème.
Hey mister, she's my sister.
So that's five miso soup, four seaweed salad, three soy burger dinner, two tofu dark platter, and one pasta with meatless balls.
Ew. It tastes the same
if you close your eyes.
And 13 orders of fries, is that it here?
Wine and beer!
Two handcrafted beers made in local breweries. To yogurt, to rice and beans and cheese. To leather, to dildos, to curry vindaloo. To huevos rancheros, to Maya Angelou. Emotion, devotion, to causing a commotion. Creation, vacation.
Mucho masturbation.
From passion to fashion.
When it's new to Sontag,
to Sondheim, anything taboo.
Ginsburg, Dylan, Cunningham, and Cage. Lenny Bruce, Langston Hughes.
To the stage, to Buddha,
to Buddha,
Papa Maruda, to. Why Garvey and Toto went over the rainbow to blow up Fancy M. La Vie Bohème.
Sisters?
We're close.
Brothers! Bisexuals, trisexuals, homo sapiens, carcinogens, hallucinogens, men, Pee-wee Herman, German, White, Turpentine, Gertrude Stein, Antonioni, Bertolucci, Kurosawa, Carmina, Burana, to apathy, to entropy, to empathy, ecstasy, Fox, Bob, Hollow, the Sex Pistols, ABC. To no shame, never playing the fame game.
To marijuana.
To sodomy, it's between God and me. To S&M.
in Bohemia. An impromptu salon will commence immediately following dinner. Maureen Johnson, just back from her spectacular one-night engagement at the 11th Street Lot, will perform Native American tribal chants backwards through her vocoder while accompanying herself on the electric cello, which she ain't never studied.
And Mark Cohen will preview his new documentary about his inability to hold an erection on the high holy days.
And Mimi Marquez, clad only in bubble wrap, will perform a famous lawn chair handcuff dance to the sounds of iced tea being stirred. And Roger will attempt to write a bittersweet evocative song
that doesn't remind us of Musetta's waltz.
Angel Dumatunard will model the latest fall fashions from Paris while accompanying herself on a 10-gallon plastic pickle tub.
And Collins will recount his exploits as anarchist, including the tale of his successful reprogramming of the MIT retro reality equipment to self-destruct as it broadcasts the words!
Actual reality! Act up! Fight
it! Excuse me, did I do something wrong? I get invited then ignored all night long.
I've been trying, I'm not lying. No one's perfect, I've got baggage.
Life's too short, babe, time is for lying. I'm looking for baggage that goes with mine.
I should tell you I've got baggage too.
Should tell you baggage,
wine and beer.
Easy tea break.
You,
me,
you,
me,
me.
Folks, I'm back. Thank you. Jason Rogers, Bohemian Grove. I have been told by a source, which I will not name. He's asked me to keep his anonymity. I will, he's told me that there's a eyes wide shut type of vid, because he knew, he saw me go into the palm, and he came out and he's like, I know what you're looking for. And I was like, do you? Cause and I think maybe he heard me talking to him, yeah, I know what you're looking for. And he told me where one is, and he told me it's another building here in Bohemian Grove Town. And it's, of course, and it's going to shock the hell out of you. The Masonic Temple is under the Chuck E. Cheese. And so I am going to the Chuck E. Cheese, and I'm going to investigate. I'm going to find out a little bit of, I'm going to find out if there's really evil in the Chuck E. Cheese, because I think there is. And I have no reason to doubt this complete stranger. I'm also going to, I think, if you really think about what it could be, if it's a Masonic Temple underneath the Chuck E. Cheese, you know what's going on. Probably through the ball pit is where they're sacrificing children. Think about it. Like, little children get in the ball pit, and then they just open it up, and it swallows the kids in, and they just fill it back up with balls, and no one ever knows either. Kids are missing all the time, probably, around here. I haven't looked. I'm sure there's kids missing. I know there's kids missing everywhere. Probably a lot of them are missing because of ball pits. Maybe we should investigate ball pits more. Why aren't we looking more into ball pits? Who's not? You know what? I'm gonna go to Chuck E. Cheese, and get to the bottom of this. Oh, that's a pretty good joke. I'm gonna get to the bottom of it. Like, I'm gonna get to the bottom of the mystery, but I'm also gonna get to the bottom of the ball pit. That's good. It's fun. That's good stuff. Okay, I gotta stay focused. We are at the Chuck E. Cheese right now. We're walking in. I've got my recording, my recording device. It's hidden, so I will be narrating as I walk around, and I will be exposing these sons of bitches for what they is. Okay, so we're walking in.
Yes,
hello. My name, yes. I'd like a table, please. No, just one person. By myself. 40-year-old man having dinner at Chuck E. Cheese. Oh, smoking or not? Really? You guys still have a smoking section? That's cool. No, I don't even smoke. Yeah, put me in that one. Shit, I haven't seen a smoking section for like 10 years. Awesome. So we're walking through. Smoking section in a kid's restaurant. That seems... Anyway. Oh, look at that. Noticing all kinds of stuff. First thing caught my eye was the ball pit. Look at that thing. Just sitting there. Menacing. It's like a gateway to hell. Skee-ball. Which, I used to love playing skee-ball as a kid. I mean, I always wanted to. My parents wouldn't let me because they told me that it was part of the devil's ultimate goal, which everything that cost money was part of the devil's ultimate goal in my family's eyes. Very religious Catholic, but not really religious on free things. If it was free, I could do it, but if it was cost any money, it had something to do with the devil. Thank you, Edna. I think you don't see a lot of Ednas, and she's got to be like 25, maybe? Anyway. Okay, so, folks, I'm going to order, and then I'll be right back. All right, folks, I'm back with my secret hidden microphone. I ordered pizza, I had some beer, a picture of it, and I'm feeling pretty good, actually. And folks, surprise, spoiler alert, the pizza at the Chuck E. Cheese in Bohemian Grove Town, pretty good. Yeah, real good. Solid pizza effort here. Impressed. Let's see. Okay, so we're going to walk around, and they told me that I'm allowed to carry the pitcher around while I walk. So I got a pitcher of beer. I'm walking, a whole pitcher of beer. Like, it's so weird. I just feel so cool. Anyway, okay, so I'm walking around. People are staring at me, by the way, because of the pitcher of beer. And I'm talking to myself. That could be it, too. All right, I'm walking around. I'm going to go check out that animatronic Chuck E. Cheese band. Go over here real quick. $5? Wow, that seems pricey. All right, well, I'm going to put the $5 in. I'm going to shut the recorder off because they play music. I don't want any copyright issues, so I'll be right back after the song's over. This ought to be interesting. $5. All right, folks, I'm back. That was the best $5 that I have ever spent. Have you guys ever seen the animatronic Chuck E. Cheese band? Oh, they take songs that are popular, like Beach Boys songs, and they change the lyrics to have them to do with, like, pizza and stuff. Oh, it was so awesome! Like, there's this once, they did this thing where they wish all girls could be pizza girls, like, instead of California girls. Oh, that is, wow, that was a lot of fun. Yeah, okay, so we're gonna go check, you know what, I'm gonna put another $5 in. I have to, I'm gonna watch it again. I'm gonna turn this off again. I'll be right back, folks. All right, folks, I'm back. The second time was even better. Let me tell you, that is fun. All right, I'm going to go over here. I'm going to keep walking and check out. I think I'm going to go check out the ball pit next. All right, I'm going to set my beer down here and jump in the ball pit, or climb into the ball pit, rather. Oh, what? Oh, I'm sorry. No, I'm too tall to be in the ball pit? Really? Where does it say that I am too tall to be in the ball pit? Oh, right there, Chuck E. Cheese holding the ruler. Oh, okay. My bad. Hey, let me ask you a question. How long you worked here for? 6 months. Is there a Masonic satanic temple underneath here that the ball pit feeds the kids, like, to them to be sacrificed? Why are you laughing? Why are you laughing and walking? It's not a joke. You know what? I think he's part of the conspiracy. I think we just, wow. I think I might have hit a little too close to home. You know? You only get ignored at first and then they accept you, or I don't know how that saying goes, but it's something to that effect. Folks, trip to Chuck E. Cheese has been pretty enlightening to me. I think we've learned a lot. I think we've learned a whole lot. First of all, my waitress Edna, who names their kid Edna nowadays? That's the first thing. Don't see a lot of Ednas. That's odd. Number two, why is it that I'm not allowed in the ball pit? I mean, I'm 6'3". I'm not, you know, why? But why don't they have adult ball pits here? That's interesting, because it would be a lot harder, I guess, to open up the ball pits and adults falling through. Maybe that's it. And I think the third thing we've learned is, this is a pretty great Chuck E. Cheese. Of all the Chuck E. Cheeses that I've been to, and I've probably been to about 35 or 40, this is the best one by far. The one in Dallas, Texas is pretty good, by the way. So check that one. That one's pretty good, too. But this one, yeah. Yeah, top notch. So, folks, I'll be right back.
I awoke only to find my lungs empty, and through the night, so it seems I'm not breathing, and now my dreams. Nothing like they were.
breaking down.
That was City in Color, Sleeping Sickness, with, of course, the great Gord Downie, the lead singer of the Tragically Hip, my favorite band. Folks, this, I think you'll agree, pretty great episode of the Rogash Podcast. Deserved 2 gold stars. Let me say that much. And another thing, folks, I think that this trip to Bohemian Grove was equal, no, fuck it. It was exceeding the one that a certain Texan from Austin took himself in the late 90s. Now, folks, Bohemian Grove is a magical, wonderful place. And there's a lot of stuff that goes on there, a lot of rumors, a lot of things you're going to hear coming out of there. And by the way, any gay rumors about me from Bohemian Grove, any you hear anything like that on the internet that, like, I was at Bohemian Grove and I may have visited a bathhouse or something, or I may have been involved in some gay naked rituals in the woods, or that is, first of all, I'm not sure that it's true, because I did take some peyote when I was there, and some mushrooms and some acid and some molly and some ecstasy. And I ended up, I'll be honest with you, I ended up in Colorado on the border. And I don't know, till this, I'm still a little bit confused about how I got home, even. But at the end of the day, I think what I learned when I was coherent in Bohemian Grove, and I lost all my recording equipment, by the way. I had video footage of the Chuck E. Cheese that I don't have anymore. It's gone. Gone forever. And it is my fault, though, because I did, you know, openly ask my cab driver if he knew where to get drugs. So I guess what I was trying to do was do some undercover work, and it just got out of hand. Folks, thank you for listening to another episode of the Rogash Podcast, and I'll tell you this right now. If you think this episode was good, go check out the last 3. They are, dare I say, fantastic. I don't want to toot my own horn, but Tootie Toot Tooterton. You know what I mean? Thank you for listening, folks. Have a great, great day.